Hi guys, Tootsie here. On this video, we're going to unbox and review this generic HDMI capture card with a loop or Passthrough, worth 700 pesos or $14. On the box, there's the HDMI logo, an image of the product itself, and a product description. There's no branding or product name. Let's open it up. Right off the bat, you'll see the capture card itself in a wrapper. Also included is a USB 2.0 to micro USB cable, a USB 2.0 to USB 2.0 cable, and some paperwork. There's no HDMI cable included, so make sure that you have an extra HDMI cable to use the pass-through. For the specifications, it uses USB 2.0 for recording. It can take up to 4K resolution for its HDMI input. It can record up to 1080p 30fps and 720p 60fps. And it has a loop or pass-through feature.
It's small, light, and its body is made of plastic.
On the right side is a USB 2.0 port for recording and an HDMI output port for the pass-through. On the left is a 5V DC micro USB input to power the device and an HDMI input port. Now that we have that out of the way, let's set this up. First, let's connect the HDMI cable from your console or a video source to the HDMI input port. Get your micro USB to USB 2.0 cable and connect it to the 5V DC input port. Connect the other end to any USB port. I decided to connect it to the switch dock.
You'll see a red light on the 5V input.
Get your USB 2.0 to USB 2.0 cable and connect one end to the USB port. Connect the other end to your computer that will be used for recording. If you're going to use the pass-through, just connect another display to the HDMI output port. For the Nintendo Switch, make sure the dock indicator is lit. If it's not, just redock the switch. Once that's done, you'll see a blue light at the HDMI input port. It's worth noting that there are other steps for capture cards to work on other devices, but we won't talk about that on this video. To test the capture card, go to the camera app in Windows. You'll see the Nintendo Switch screen. But if you have a camera connected, just click on the Switch camera icon. You'll notice that there's no sound. To fix this, go to Control Panel, Hardware and Sound, Sound, then go to the Recording tab. Right-click on the Digital Audio Interface and click Properties. Go to the Listen tab and check Listen to this device. Click Apply, then OK. Go back to the camera app and check if you hear the Nintendo Switch's audio. Now let's do some tests. First, I'll estimate the latency of the capture card, then show you some sample recording at 1080p and 720p. For the latency test, I use a laptop to record my desktop computer screen. What you see on my computer screen is just a slideshow. After counting the number of frames between the appearance of the square, I found that the latency is 133 milliseconds. Now, here are some sample recordings. Start. Overall, this capture card records good quality with decent latency for only 700 pesos. If you are just going to use it for your camera, for streaming, or to share some gameplay with your friends, I'd say go for this. I don't think people will care about the latency. Even if it's limited to 30 FPS at 1080p, it's still good for its price. Plus, you can achieve 60 FPS at 720p anyway. The only downside to this capture card is not being able to play games that heavily depend on your reaction time on the software preview. But you can always use the Passthrough to solve this problem. I would really recommend this, especially for people who are in a tight budget. Thanks for watching, and like if you enjoyed this video, and subscribe for more gaming, art, and other content.